So I'm standing in front of the Kremlin in Moscow. It's one of those most iconic buildings that you've got to see, but it's freezing, it's minus 15 degrees. But the real reason I'm here, by the way, the Moscow River's just over there, have a quick look, it's frozen. It's absolutely frozen solid. But the real reason I'm here is that there's a trip I've always wanted to do in my life, and we're about to set off tomorrow on the Trans-Siberian Express heading for Beijing.
The adventure starts in a snowy Moscow, and then the train heads right the way across Russia, through Mongolia, to Beijing, over 9,000 kilometers away. But first, Moscow, named after the river that runs right the way through it. Moscow itself is over 600 years old. The Kremlin is still the home of the president. Kremlin has many, many discoveries. It's beautiful architecture, but some of it is even underground.
So before we get on the train, what we decided to do is come here a couple of days earlier just to make sure that we'd actually seen the sights of Moscow, and that's what I'd recommend. It's so cold, get yourself a Russian hat. And after seeing the Kremlin and the other sights, the other thing that we've been told to do is have a ride on the metro, so another train, on the Circle Line. That's what we've got to try and find out. So first of all, we've just got to find out how to buy a ticket in here.
I find when travelling that some of the most simplest things, like buying a rail ticket, turn out to be the most challenging.
Спасибо большое. I bought tickets, but I don't know where to. It's our first Russian train experience.
We were told to have a ride on the metro, and it certainly gives you an idea how real life rolls out in the city. But one of the reasons that we were getting squeezed onto the carriages under the freezing streets above was to see the amazing architecture of some of the stations. Some of it really referenced the colourful history of this amazing country, the strong images and the strong sculptures, but some of them had some surprises behind them.
People keep touching certain parts of these sculptures, and we're not quite sure why, but this dog keeps getting stroked.
We soon found out that by touching it, it was supposed to make your dreams come true.
So it's good luck if you touch the dog. Thank you very much.
A fascinating start to our adventure, but now we were looking forward to getting on board the Trans-Siberian Express.